Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to use new task action through Lightning Scheme Flow. So we can create tasks using Lightning Flows. So I will be demonstrating. So if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube. And you can watch various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages on my channel. So do follow it. So now here you can see I have already implemented basic Lightning Flow, which is to create context. So here you can see I have one screen component that is last name. Then I am going to create a new context, and this context will be automatically related to an account. So I am receiving record ID as input and assigning last name. Now I am creating one more variable so that I can store this contact ID. So creating new resource variable, its API name will be contact ID and its data type is text, and clicking on done. So here it is. So this contact ID variable will be receiving the newly created contact record, and here you can see I created record ID, so it will receive input. And input will be account record ID. So whenever you want to receive records ID automatically, then you need to create record ID variable in flows. Now, after this create record, I'm going to put action element, that is create new task. So you can search for new task. Here it is, quick action. So you can use this. So create a task. So just after creation of contact record, a new task will be created, and you can assign that task to a particular user. So let's say here you can see this required field is available, assigned to ID. So to which a user you want to assign this newly created task. So here I'm going to create new resource as formula. So let's say its API is logged in user. And its data type will be text. And here I'm going to create a formula to identify current logged in user ID. Right? So this way I am able to fetch the current logged in user ID, and I'm clicking on done. So here it is. So this record will be assigned to the user who is creating the record, a contact record, and that task record will be assigned to that user only. Then these are some optional values, you can fill them. So let's say due date. So here also you need to create one more resource to fill this date. So I'm not populating it. Then here name ID. So here we can put that contact ID. So this task will be automatically linked with this contact. Then other optional values are also available. Let's say subject. I'm filling as call, and you can fill status as well. So I'm not populating this as of now. So I'm clicking on done. So you can fill all those values as per your requirement. Now I'm connecting this, saving it as a new version, and clicking on activate. Now I'm going to use this screen flow on account record page. So I'm just clicking on edit on account record page so that I can simply drag and drop that flow component. So here at left hand side, you can see this flow component is available. So I'm just dragging and dropping it on account record page. So here it is. So it is having create contact, and you need to check this checkbox so that current record ID will be passed to this flow. I'm saving this, clicking on back. Now I can create new contact, and you will see a new task will be created automatically through that flow. So right now you can see this account is having two related contacts. So now I'm creating one more. So test task, this is the last name. Clicking on next. So here you can see this record is created, I'm opening it on a new tab, and you will see a new task will be created or should be created automatically. So here at right hand side, you can see this is the task that is created automatically. I'm opening it in new window so that you can see its details. So it is opening, and here you can see task tab is automatically opened, and it is assigned to me because I am the current logged in user. Subject is call. Status, we didn't provide it. Name, name is the record to which it is related. And due date, we didn't fill. Priority is normal, that is populated by default. So this way you can see those fields which we populated are filled and others are blank. So this way, I hope you understood how we can create a new task using Lightning Flow. So this is pretty much important, and it will help you in your projects and assignments. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this flow. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube, and you can watch various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages on my YouTube channel. So thank you for watching this video.